In 1968, the city of Flint, Michigan became the first city in the nation to pass an open housing referendum outlawing discrimination in housing. The vote upheld an ordinance passed by the city commission. It made national news and civil rights history. Before the vote, Black families and individuals had been systematically kept out of white neighborhoods in the city. It had become common practice for real estate agents to not show homes to Black families and individuals. The changes began in August of 1967 when the city commission voted against a fair housing ordinance which would have prevented discrimination in housing in the city. When the vote was announced, Mayor Floyd McCree, the city's first Black mayor, threatened to resign in protest. Flint residents staged a sleep-in in front of City Hall, and Michigan Governor George Romney showed up at the unity rally at the end of a 10-day protest attended by 4,000 people. With thousands of residents demanding its passage in October of 1967, the city commission finally reversed course and approved the ordinance. But a group against the ordinance called the committee to repeal forced housing, campaigned against the open housing referendum, claiming that the ordinance usurped the rights of property owners. The group collected petitions and forced the issue on the ballot. Led by Mayor McCree, open housing activists and volunteers went on a grueling 7-day-a-week campaign for passage of the ordinance. They went door-to-door talking to residents, held rallies at meeting halls, and passed out campaign literature to tens of thousands of Flint voters. Black and white religious leaders and churches throughout Flint supported the vote and mobilized for the efforts to approve the open housing ordinance. On the election night of February 20th, 1968, hundreds of Flint residents, housing activists, and campaign volunteers gathered around Mayor McCree to hear the then devastating news about the vote. The mayor announced that the vote failed, and the atmosphere around him was one of abject misery, as reported by the Flint Journal newspaper that night. But joy comes in the morning. It wasn't until the next morning on February 21st that Flint election officials realized they had made a mathematical error. The vote had instead passed by a very slim 43-vote margin, about 0.1% of the more than 40,000 votes cast. Flint voters approved the housing ordinance against discrimination, the first of its kind approved in the nation. After the correct results were announced, Mayor McCree told the Flint Journal, "It's just wonderful. The people won."
The Negro population has become very keenly aware of the need for their stand on civil rights and feel that they must register if they are going to have any part in determining just how far the civil rights issue is going to go.
We've been built and we've been scorned. We've been treated bad, talked about, as sure as you born. But just as sure as it takes 2 eyes to make a pair, brother, we can't quit until we get our share. We'll be right back. change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. It's been too hard living, but I'm afraid to die. 'Cause I don't know what's up there beyond the sky. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Somebody keep telling me don't hang around. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes, it will. Then I go to my brother. Say, brother, help me, please. But he winds up knocking me back down on my knees. Lord, there have been times that I thought I couldn't last for long.
I'm not sure if we're at that point at this particular time, but I am certain that within the very near future, with the trend of unemployment in the Flint area, that we would most certainly qualify as a depressed area.